The wild year of 2020 is over. Here are three lessons I'm taking forward with me into 2021. Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. And if you're new here, my name is Hassan. I'm a third year medical student at UCL. Before we go any further, I've linked timestamps in the description below, so please feel free to check them out and skip ahead to any sections that interest you. Without further ado, let's begin. The first lesson is something that I struggled with a lot personally, but once I heard the saying, it really helped me to put it into perspective what I was thinking and why. The saying goes, measure the gain, not the gap. Now my interpretation of this is measure the gain from when you started, rather than measuring the gap from the person you are today to your ideal self or your future self or even other people. Now this is something I struggled with a lot. And I always thought I wasn't performing at my best if I wasn't performing at my ideal self. We can't compare ourselves against our ideal self because A, that might not even be realistic for us, and B, because once you fall short, this will just make you feel like you're not performing your best and it'll make you feel like you're not good enough. By constantly comparing yourself to others or even your ideal self, this is just a recipe for disaster. It really hit home for me when somebody told me that I'm me. I'm not the person that I'm looking up to, or I'm not somebody else. At the end of the day, I'm me and I will do what I could do. I shouldn't be comparing myself to somebody else's life and saying, why can't I do that? Or I should be able to do that. Now this is something I did implicitly. I didn't explicitly have these thoughts, but it's something I sort of did inside, and once I recognized it, it's something that I've been actively trying to stop. I can't compare myself on the journey that I'm on with somebody else's journey, where they could be on a completely different journey, or they can be at a different stage of their journey. I've not done this for YouTube, but I can see how it can be easy to compare yourself to somebody that has been making videos for 5 years and feel like you're not good enough. But the important thing to remember is to measure the gain, not the gap. The person that has been doing it for 5 years has had a lot more experience than you if you're just starting off. So by measuring the gain from when you started, so I started about 6-7 weeks ago and I've made 6 videos. To be honest, I'm really, really happy with the progress I've made because I love making these videos. I love editing them. I love sort of giving value, and I love the creative output that YouTube allows me to have. But if I was constantly comparing myself to somebody who is years ahead, then I would never feel happy and I would never acknowledge the progress that I've made so far. The second lesson of today is the power of accountability. Now, honestly, this has been a complete game changer for me, from my studies to YouTube to, well, that's pretty much it, studies and YouTube. But having people to study with really does push you a lot further. So when it came to studying, I could never study at home. Like through secondary school, college, and even university, I've never been able to study at home, only the library. And that's because it was an environment where I felt motivated, other students were there, everybody else was studying, and it sort of pushes you to study even more. But since being at home, and just since university being online and just studying by yourself in your bedroom, it can become very easy to sort of fall off and not realize, but the whole day will go by, and you've not done any work, you've not been productive at all, and you just sort of binge Netflix all day. What I've done to combat this is I've set up a Zoom call with the people in my course twice a week, 12 till 3. Now this forces me to wake up and to attend the Zoom call, and it gives me that accountability to study, and it gives me the accountability to run the Zoom call. It's always so much nicer studying with other people than studying with yourself. And another benefit of this is we all do the same course, so we can very easily ask for help and sort of talk about the course, and it just becomes a lot less lonely. Rather than doing it yourself in your bedroom, it's so much nicer when you're collaborating with other people. Accountability also works for waking up early. This is something I've struggled with a lot. Unless I have a reason to wake up in the morning, whether it be working over summer or university in person, then I really struggle to get out of bed. To combat this, I'm going to use some more of that cheeky accountability and try scheduling calls with my friends in the morning, or even scheduling my Urdu lessons to be in the morning rather than the afternoon. And this will then force me to get up early and to get out of bed and start my day on time. My third and final lesson for this video is to always optimize for happiness. Now, I'm not sure why I haven't thought about this before, but since thinking about happiness more and more, I've been trying to find ways to optimize for it. At the end of the day, we shouldn't be feeling negative about the stuff that we're doing, especially if it's something that we want to do. For example, the course that I'm doing, maths and computing, I shouldn't be feeling negative and I shouldn't be feeling stressed or burnt out because of it. At the end of the day, I chose it because it's something that I wanted to do, and I should try to keep that in mind as much as possible. Now, the reasons for me feeling stressed or maybe burnt out could be due to poor time management or various other factors. So the important thing to consider is how can I optimize for happiness in this situation? And to optimize for happiness in this situation would be to get my work done on time. And so I've created a routine around studying where I don't leave anything till last minute and everything can be done in a specified time. And I can then take my time to enjoy the course and to enjoy everything that I'm learning and really take it in. That's just one example. But another part of optimizing for happiness is not being too hard on yourself. Now this is definitely something that I've struggled with, where if I don't wake up on time or if I oversleep or whatever else, I'll be really hard on myself. And this sort of negativity is just never good for you. It causes me to spiral and I'll just end up binging the whole day watching Netflix because I'm feeling crappy about myself, rather than forgiving myself for waking up late and just sort of letting it go and being a lot easier on myself. So then I can have a more positive outlook on the rest of the day. And I think more and more on ways on how to optimize happiness in my own life, because I feel like happiness is the most important thing that you can optimize for. And I feel like it's definitely something that you should always consider. A lot of us are always tired and stressed, whether it's work or studying. So I guess if you take only one thing away from this video, it's that to always optimize for happiness. Now, I really can't emphasize this enough. And I really want you guys to sort of take this away and see if you can find ways to optimize happiness in your own lives. I do feel like this is like a really important thing that not many of us focus on. If you guys enjoyed this, then check out my other video on 10 life lessons I learned in 2020. Thank you for watching, have a great day, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Peace.